We have been closed for about 2 years because we've been having some really, really significant work done on the building. All that work's been up in the top floors, but that has meant that we've had this huge scaffolding. And that huge scaffolding had to be backpropped all the way down to the ground floor so that the weight of it didn't cause the whole building to collapse. We don't want that. And obviously, to do that backpropping, we had to move around a lot of the material down in the Irish room. And the giant deer, we have it on display in the entrance space, were those things that happened to be in the way and were the worst to move, because unlike the cases, which you kind of had to work around, they're mobile enough to be able to move them, and they're right where we needed to have quite a significant amount of backpropping. So what we've done is we've built these kind of what we call stillages around the main specimens so that we can move them and secure them while they're moving so they don't rattle around too much, because any movement like that can damage the bone. It's quite brittle, it's you know, fossil. It's not kind of modern bone with a lot of spring in it, so it can break quite easily. And for some of the specimens, we were able to build a kind of frame to hold the skull in place. But for this one, when we got up and had a look at how it was attached, we weren't happy with the way in which it was secured, and we didn't feel it would be safe to move it in that way. So what we did was to take the skull off so that we could move everything safely. And now we're getting ready to put it back on again, which is a fairly significant piece of work in itself. This is one of the largest racks of antlers in the world. It's around 3.53 metres, which is huge. The biggest is 3.60 metres. And it's heavy. And normally it would be the first thing you see when you come into the building with this huge span of antlers standing right at the front door. And this is down in the Irish room because, of course, it's an Irish deer. So one of the things we've had to do is to build a new support system for it, because the previous system wasn't very good, and the skull's it's very old, and it's clearly been damaged in the past, and there's been some conservation work done on it historically, and we're talking 100 years ago, probably more. And what we wanted to do is just make sure that was all still safe, and so we've been fitting a steel armature which is going to take the weight of that skull and put it through the rest of the frame to make sure it's all really stable and static without posing any risk to the actual specimen itself.